So how'd you like those two pieces? Absolutely love to hear that. Well, I'm going to take this time to formally introduce myself and also to welcome you all to my graduating recital. And for those who don't know me, even though you probably saw it on a poster, I'm Joey Cantarutti, and obviously this is my graduating recital. And now, you might realize the setup here. You might be asking me a couple questions. You might be thinking, Joe, what's with the weird setup you have here? Why do you have a metronome on top of a snare drum? Or why do you have this big bass drum with a bunch of other drums with a bunch of wood blocks? That makes me confused and somewhat scared. So I'm actually gonna tell you that. So beginning after my third year recital and knowing that this is my last time hitting, being on the stage here in this big, beautiful Jennifer Velva Bernstein Performance Hall, I wanted to basically ask this question to myself. How am I going to achieve the limits of being a percussionist at this point? And how will I essentially live with no regrets for the end of my final year? And the end of this, and the answer is what you see here before you. And I wanted to demonstrate every single aspect of percussion I could possibly can, showing on the marimba, on the snare drum with metronome, the timpanis, and multi-percussion. And this next piece, well, actually, I'll tell you about the pieces before. The first piece I played was Caleidoscópio by the two mallet king himself, Koshinski. And then the second piece was Sleight of and Evil Hand by my personal favorite percussion composer, Casey Cangelosi. And this next piece I'm gonna play for you right now is entitled Bushido, The Way of the Warrior by John Willmarth on the timpanis. And there'll be three movements, Jin, Meiyo, and you.
Thank you.
So how'd you like those two pieces? All right, this is it. Last one. But before I conclude my undergraduate career here at Queens, I'd like to say a couple words of thanks to some very, very important people. First of which, I'd like to thank my family who are out in the audience. Just wave. There you go. There you go. I did not even know that many people were coming here, so I'm eternally grateful for that. And also, you know, throughout the past 13 years of music, you know, your never-ending support, consistently motivating me, and also keeping my head in check a little bit. But your eternal support, I am very grateful for, so I'd like to thank you very much for that, so thank you. And there are a couple profs in the audience I'd like to thank. First of which, who actually he's adjudicating me right now, Sean Donaldson. Wait for the crowds. There you are. So for those who don't know, Professor Donaldson, he came in this year because we actually had about 12 percussionists, and we only had one professor. So I don't think that would have suited. That would have been a bit overwhelming. But Sean, we are very grateful for you to come back here. You know, show your wisdom, show your techniques, a little bit, and showing off sometimes and humbling us. But, you know, and for those who don't know, when my first year, when Greg took a leave of absence, Sean came in and filled the void, and filled that teaching void that where we were kind of wondering about. So he was my teacher for three months until the pandemic hit. But throughout those 3 months, honestly, I don't know if I would have been in performance without you, Sean. So you are just as big of an influence as Greg was. So thank you very much. And lastly, the man, the legend himself, Professor Greg Runyons. The man. Oh man. Where do I start? Oh man, like, ever since you took me in, you know, you took a chance on me, and basically beating me over the head about basically stripping me down to my basic techniques and then basically rebuilding me back up. But I was eternally grateful for that. And also just through your advice, your never-ending support, consistently bringing out the best in me and everybody in the percussion studio. I think we can all say that as a fact. I think some people from the percussion studio can say that you brought out the best in us, and just making this environment such a wonderful environment to be in throughout the past 4 years, even during the pandemic. And you are one of the biggest inspirations I've had in my life. And, oh man, this is harder than I thought. But your inspiration has no bounds, and I will continue to take your advice, especially when I move out into the real world as I continue my master's degree. So thank you very much. And lastly, I want to thank the incredible staff here at the Isabel Bader, you know, for helping set this up, helping set up the live stream. Hey guys, how y'all doing at home? And the lighting crew, the sound crew, who has just been nothing but amazing, accommodating, and just some of the best people in the world. And I also like to thank the percussion studio, you know, my friends who are here in the audience today, who are out watching me live stream. You guys made these past 4 years some of the best 4 years of my life at this point. You know, I don't know where I would have been without you guys, you know, consistently supporting me and being some of the best friends I've ever had. And lastly, I want to thank all of you for the audience here tonight. Today, I mean, afternoon. Jesus, it's not that late. I want to thank all of you for coming out here, you know, sharing this moment with me. And you know, there wouldn't be a recital here without you. Otherwise, I would have been staring into the faces of Sean and our other amazing adjudicator, Dan Tremblay. And I probably would have been maybe in the fetal position sucking my thumb at this point. So, you know, I'm just kidding. Anyways, I'd like to officially thank you for coming out, and I wish you all a very great day. This last tune is called Moon Chasers by Mark Ford.
Thank you.